सीआर पटेल आ रही है
सर इरिन सर इरिन
स्टार्ट मारना होगा
हाँ स्टार्ट मारी सर
स्टार्ट मारना होगा
हाँ सर
कड़े ना डिस्टर्बेंस किया ऐसे
हाँ अंदर वॉइस अल्प इधर आती है सर वॉइस अल्प ब्रेक आती है
ವಾಯ್ಸ್ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ಆಗ್ತಿದೆ ನಾನು ಮೊಬೈಲ್ ಇಂದ ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ ನಾನು ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಈಗ ಈಗ ಕೇಳಿಸ್ತಿದ್ಯಾ
ಕೇಳಿಸ್ತಿದೆ ಸರ್ ಆದ್ರೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ಆಗ್ತಿದೆ ಸರ್ ಅಷ್ಟೇ
ಹೌದಾ ಏನು ಮಾಡೋದು ಪಟೇಲ್ ಈಗ ಕೇಳಿಸ್ತಿದ್ಯಾ ಪಟೇಲ್
ಸರ್ ಈಗ ಈಗ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಕೇಳಿಸ್ತಿದೆ ಸರ್
ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ ದನ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ದ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಆಲ್
ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಸರ್
ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಸರ್
ಟುಡೇ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಅನದರ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಟಾಪಿಕ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ಆನ್ ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಗ್ರೋ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಓಕೆ I think in last class I explained what is mean by social forestry then agroforestry we're explaining the branches of forestry alwa so we'll discuss one by one okay what is social forest what is the types and what is the objective and benefits and what are the advantages of these you know forest types of forestry so coming to the social forestry okay social forestry refers to the management of the forest for the beneficial mainly for the beneficial local commuter or the local people okay and it includes the includes the aspects such as forest management okay forest management is overall administrative then also economic you know aspects okay and also the forest protection from different like abiotic and biotic factors then also the afforestation of you know deforested lands with the objective of improving rural and also environmental condition of the particular area or maybe the you know rural areas and also its aims on social development and unlike other forestry projects in the you know setting of social forestry it needs the local communities first okay it's you know needs the involvement of the local communities in different forest activities and for this reason you know the main goal of the social forestry is to grow the trees and plantations to meet different you know needs of people or the community in reference to increase the demand demand for timber wood and fuel then also for the food and the food to reduce the pressure and dependency on other traditional you know forest like traditional forest that means on you know natural forest so and the social forestry the it is also the practice also aims to protect the agriculture from adverse climatic conditions by improving the environment and also increase the natural beauty of the area and also increasing the supply of forest produce for the local use that is for the you know use of community or it may be the people living around that region okay and also it addresses the human forest interaction and mainly the importance of the community based natural resource management so coming to the different types of the social forestry and the social forestry are divided into four types one is agroforestry then the farm forestry then urban forestry and another one is community forestry okay we'll discuss one by one and first one is agroforestry maybe in future slides I will discuss regarding agroforestry what is the features what is the you know benefits and advantages disadvantages of this agroforestry okay we'll move on to another type that is farm forestry I think I discussed in last class about farm for what is farm for definition of farm forestry okay it is a practice of cultivating and managing the trees in the compact blocks on agriculture mainly in agriculture lands okay it is called as farm forestry then farm forestry mainly offers many benefits that include mainly it provides the shelter and also the fodder or pasture for the animals then additional diversified earnings that is we are also getting some income from the trees then also improved you know living environment that is these trees farm forestry or maybe the planted trees in agriculture land it increases the microclimate or aesthetic condition of that area and also it increases the capital value of the plantation then also it improvement and maintenance of soil and water health then also it mainly aims on sustainable management of natural resources that is maybe it may be the soil water or air okay and it also increases the you know diversity of the area so another type of the social forestry it is you know community forestry mainly what community forestry means the forestry refers to the management of communal lands that is the land belongs to the you know village or maybe panchayat like that okay and the communal lands it is not you know belongs to the individual person it belongs to the you know villagers then the village members collectively decide and implement the project on the communal lands then the combination of forest conservation with rural development and poverty you know reduction objectives it accomplished through the you know instanting a legal framework that favors the you know profitable and sustainable forest management activities in the you know communal land by the you know people then the main purpose of these community forestry is to increase the you know involvement of the peoples in different you know projects or maybe different activities and also it rewards for the local people the that is it provides the many you know benefits for the people like it may provide food and also for the fodder then fuel then timber these will you know activities mainly involved in the you know community forestry by the people so another type of forestry is extension forestry okay extension forestry means the planting of trees on the sides of roads then canals and also railway along with the planting and the way maybe these extension forestry is conducted in the wastelands it is known as wasteland means it is maybe degraded lands or eroded lands or maybe the lands you know non cultivable lands okay from you know in this lands the trees are cultivating this you know cultivating this the forestry called as extension forestry okay and this type of social forestry is mainly beneficial in the you know creation of forest on the common village lands and also maybe the panchayat land and government wastelands okay then also here national commission on agriculture 1976 okay it classify the social forestry into three kinds okay one is urban forestry and rural forestry and farm forestry I think we discussed what is farm forestry and the rural forestry means the you know rural forestry lays emphasis on mainly the promotion of agroforestry and community forestry okay then urban forestry means I think this is also I you know explained in the previous class. Okay, it means it entitles the care and management of the urban tree populations for the purpose of improving the urban environment. Okay, and also for the maintaining of aesthetic condition of the area. Okay, the main benefit from these agro urban forestry is it improves the urban environment by provide by creating aesthetic the good aesthetic condition in the region. Then coming to the another important topic, that is the agro forestry. Okay, so I am audible to all now?
Yes sir, yes sir.
No problem. Yes, sir. My voice.
Yes sir.
Okay. So we'll discuss about agroforestry. Okay, I think you are all know about you are all know definition agroforestry, I think. So Darshan
sir, it is sir. Darshan,
what is agroforestry? What is mean by agroforestry? ಹೇಳ್ಬೇಕ್, ಸುಮ್ನೆ ಇರಬಾರ್ದು, ಹೇಳ್ಬೇಕ್ ಏನೋ ಒಂದು. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೀನ್ ಬೈ ಅಗ್ರೋ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ದರ್ಶನ್? ಆಗ್ಲೇ ಮರ್ತ್ ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ರಾ? ಆಗ್ಲೇ ತಾನೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಸೈಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ, ನೋಡ್ಲಿಲ್ವಾ? ದೀಪ್ತಿ, ಆರ್ ಯು ದೇರ್?
ಯೆಸ್ ಸರ್.
ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೀನ್ ಬೈ ಅಗ್ರೋ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ರಿ
ಸರ್? ಇಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ species and livestock sir.
That's a good. Darshan, yen martidira neevu?
Sir, illa idin sir.
Maneyalli martidira, amma enadru madidra tinkondirthira anusutte?
Illa sir, innan tindine madilla.
Okay, paravagilla, yenagala. So agroforestry means it is integration of woody perennials, that is tree species, with agriculture with agriculture crops and livestock. Okay, in same piece of land same management unit. Okay, it is and coming to the features of the main features of agroforestry, the main features of agroforestry is it is multi storied production of different species, that is tree species at higher story and agriculture crops at lower story. Okay, this is called multi storied cropping. Maybe I will explain in future slides what is multi story crops and all. Okay, then also the agroforestry is a 6F program because it provides food, feed, fiber, then fuel, furniture means timber, and also funds. Okay, funds means the income. So coming to the different attributes of these agroforestry system. Okay, first one is productivity, then sustainability and adaptability. Okay, we'll discuss one by one what is productivity and sustainability and adaptability. Okay, there are three attributes which all the agroforestry system possess. Okay, first one is productivity. Productivity means the agroforestry system aims to maintain or increase the production as well as productivity. Productivity means it is a inherent capacity of the land or maybe the area to produce. Okay, produce or production something, maybe yield or the fertility of the soil. Okay, it is called as productivity. And also agroforestry can improve the productivity in many different ways. That includes increase the output of the tree production. Maybe the income or timber, it increases the timber value or the aesthetic condition of that area or the yield of in general it is yield of the tree. Okay, and also it improves the yield yields of the associated crops, that is the mainly the agriculture crops associated with the tree species. Okay, and the reduction of cropping system inputs, that is into maybe the fertilizer, maybe the water requirement or others. Okay, or pesticide requirement other. Then also it increase the labor efficiency also. Then another attributes of agroforestry is that is sustainability, and it is mainly based on conserving the production potential of the resources what present in the agroforestry system. Then mainly taught the beneficial effects of woody perennials on soil, that is the beneficial effects means nutrient recycling, carbon sequestration, maybe the kind of erosion of control, all these include under the sustainable agroforestry system. Then it achieve and indefinitely maintain the conservation and fertility goals, that is it conserve the water and also soil, okay, and also it say at the same time it increases the fertility of the soil by adding the organic matter to the soil. Then another the attribute is adaptability. Adaptability means any the agroforestry model or systems developed in lab or maybe other field, okay, it should be accepted by the all farming community, that is called as adaptability, okay. Implication is improved or new agroforestry technologies, okay, and introduced into a new area should also be conformed to local farming practices, okay. So next one is the different benefits of the agroforestry. First one, there are three types of agro benefits. The first one is environmental benefits, then social economic benefits, and social benefits, okay. We'll discuss one by one what is environmental benefit and social benefits and economic benefits, okay. First one is environmental benefits, okay. The agroforestry reduces the pressure on natural forest and also enhance the better production of ecological system, okay. Then also increases the biodiversity of particular area by favoring different environmental conditions. Then it improves the microclimate of the area by lowering of soil mainly temperature. Then also reduction in evaporation and maintenance of soil moisture. Then also it the agroforestry system reduces runoff and also nutrient leaching and soil erosion. Another environmental benefit is it improves the soil fertility through addition of litter fall, okay. And another benefit environmental benefit is it enhances efficient nutrient recycling of the different nutrients within the soil at different depths, okay. And it improves the soil structure by addition of organic matter to the soil, and also it lowers the bulk density of the soil, and also simultaneously it increases organic carbon content in the soil. So this is different environmental benefits of agroforestry system. And next one is the economic benefits, okay. Economic mainly the agroforestry yields increases the output per unit area, that is more crops per unit area, so that more crop means more income from small unit area or from the same management unit. Then agroforestry system reduces the total crop failure, okay. For example, if agriculture crop failures, then the tree species will give the income, okay. If tree species are not able to give the income from different like timber, from timber or from other sources, then the agriculture crops will generate the income for the farmers, okay. That is called as that is agroforestry system reduces total crop failure, okay. Then third one is all these benefits are resultant to increase the whole farm income for the farmers, okay. Then next one is the social benefits of agroforestry. The agroforestry mainly improves the rural living standards by increasing the income income of the farmers in a sustained manner, okay. Then also it improvement the health and also nutrition of the people, because it provides food for the your people. Then also it creates some good micro climatic condition in the region, okay. Then also the multiple outputs with the risk of total failure stabilize the farm commodities, okay. it also provide different you know commodities required for the you know farming community or maybe the people. Okay, then coming to the important characteristics of the trees that you know the plant species suitable for the agroforestry system. Okay, we'll discuss one by one what is you know different characters of trees and the different species that is mainly you know required for the planting in agroforestry system. So first one is the trees species selected should not interfere with soil moisture. Okay, that it means the tree species selected for agroforestry should have very less water requirement, and also it should not be compete with the main agricultural crops for water or moisture. Then trees species should you know always deep rooted one so that they can draw the water or nutrient from the deeper layers of the soil. Then the next one is the tree species should not compete you know for the plant nutrients. So tree species should not utilize more plant nutrients, and it should help in building you know soil fertility. Okay, mainly this should be involved in maintaining of soil fertility other than agriculture crops. Okay, then mainly the legume tree species should be you know planted in agroforestry system, because the you know the leguminous tree species will fix the you know atmospheric nitrogen in their roots, and it results the increase in the plant nutrients in the soil. So another the character is the tree species should not be compete for the sunlight. Trees you know the tree species should not you know compete with for the sunlight falling on the agriculture crops, and also tree species should be light branching in their habit. Okay, if more branching, it will you know reduce the sunlight falling on agriculture crops. Okay, it blocks the light penetration to the lower levels. Then the tree permits the penetration of light into the ground, and also promote the better growth of you know maybe the crops or maybe the you know fodder crops. Okay, tree species can withstand the pruning operation if it is possess you know dense canopy. Then another one is tree species should have a high survival rate and easy establishment. Okay, the tree species should be have high survival percentage. Okay, and also leave you know little or no gaps after transplanting. Mainly the hardy tree species are easy to establish in agroforestry system. Then also it you know these hardy species are maybe it will grow better compared to other tree species. Then another one is tree species should have fast growing habit and easy establishment. The tree species for agroforestry system should be you know essentially fast growing one, that is rapid growth, you know, especially in early stages of tree growth and development. Then next important character is tree species should have wider adaptability to the different conditions. Okay, that a tree species selected for agroforestry combination must have a wider adaptability to different climatic conditions. Then sixth one is the trees seventh one is the tree species should have high palatability, has you know palatability as a powder. Okay, it means the most of Indian farmers you know rear livestock separately and cut and carry the you know carry method of fodder production it is in common in our you know Indian farming system. So therefore in you know agroforestry, the farmer must select those species which are palatable to livestock and had a high digestibility fodder by the livestock. Okay, so next one is the tree species should have shelter conferring and soil stabilization attributes. It means some tree species because of their you know growth habit and adaptability are especially helps in providing protection for the soil, and also for the crops and livestock. Okay, like example, like popular species Casuarina, Equisetifolia, for have been extensively used in soil erosion control because their extensive root system and also the ability to grow in waterlogged, mainly in waterlogged soils and degraded degraded or it may be the eroded lands. Then ninth one is the tree species should have capacity capability to withstand management practices. Okay, it means many agroforestry system demand extensively pruning and looping of the trees in order to maximize the production. In such cases the trees must be able to management practices like the pruning, then thinning activities, then podding. These should be the trees should be withstand the different management practices while planting in agroforestry system. Then another character is the tree species should have nutrients recycling and also nitrogen fixing attributes. So within the agroforestry system, the trees can play an important role in recycling of different nutrients from different layer. Okay, mainly the leguminous tree species will fix the atmospheric nitrogen in their roots. Okay, and these nutrients are used in growth and development of the different tree species planted in agroforestry system. And the many returning to the top soil in the form of dead leaves, that is the litter fall, okay, mainly increases once the litter fall undergo decomposition. It adds the different nutrients into the soil, mainly the organic carbon or the total organic carbon into the soil. So next one is the tree species should be have it thin bark. Okay, mainly that's tree species selected for agroforestry system. ಪಟೇಲ್ ಕೇಳಿಸಿದ್ಯಾ? ಹಲೋ
ಹಲೋ ಸರ್,
ಕೇಳಿಸಿದ್ಯಾ? ಸೊ ಲೆವೆಂತ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಟ್ರೀ ಸ್ಪೀಶೀಸ್ ವುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಥಿನ್ ಬಾರ್ಕ್. ಇಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ದ ಟ್ರೀ ಸ್ಪೀಶೀಸ್ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅಗ್ರೋ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಶೆಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಬಾರ್ಕ್ ರೆಗ್ಯುಲರ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ದ ಥಿನ್ ಥಿಕ್ ಬಾರ್ಕ್ ದ ಟ್ರೀ ಸ್ಪೀಶೀಸ್ ವಿಲ್ they shed the the bark in maybe frequently they shed the bark. Okay, if thin bark, it will not shed the their bark frequently. Okay, then next one is tree species should be free from chemical exudations, that is it should not affect on other crop, that is some of the trees like example like eucalyptus, okay, it produces allelochemicals. Okay, that means the chemicals it affect the growth of other tree species. Okay. It means this is selected for agroforestry the must be free from allelochemicals, as these allelochemicals mainly affect the growth of underground crop, that is mainly the agriculture crops. The next one, the tree species should have easily decomposable leaves.
Hello sir, yaro mic off madilla.
ಯಾರಪ್ಪ ಆಫ್ ಮಾಡ್ರ ಮೈಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಾಡ್ರ ನನಗೂ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಫುಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟರ್ಬೆನ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ, ಆಫ್ ಮಾಡ್ರಿ, ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಿಲ್ಲ ಇದಾಗಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಟ್ರೀ ಸ್ಪೀಶೀಸ್ ಶುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಈಸಿಲಿ ಡಿಕಂಪೋಸಬಲ್ ಲೀವ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ದ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ದ ಸೂಟೇಬಲ್ ಟ್ರೀ ಸ್ಪೀಶೀಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅಗ್ರೋಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದಟ್ ಒನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಫಾಲನ್ ಲೀವ್ಸ್ ಲೀವ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಲಿಟರ್ ಡಿಕಂಪೋಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಫಾಸ್ಟರ್ ರೇಟ್. ಓಕೆ, the leaves, most of the legume tree species are small in size, and it will decompose quickly and easily, and frequently it will add nutrients to the soil. Then also the tree species having broad leaves such as maybe teak or mango, then banyan, should not be preferred for agroforestry system. Okay, the leaves, it may take the longer period for the decomposition of the leaf. Then next one is the tree species should have their multiple uses. Okay, that is in the practical classes I explained. Okay, mainly the tree species should be multi-purpose. Okay, like example, like milliardubia. Okay, it provides mainly fodder. It provides the fodder, then also timber, and also the tree species used in plywood and pulp industries. Okay, the tree species should be have multiple uses. That is, tree should yield more than one of the main produce, like it may be used for fuel wood or leaf that is used for fodder. Then the fruits are used for the consumption. Then also the flowers and the fibers. The last one is the tree species should have a high yield potential. That means high yield potential is the most important criteria for the selection of different tree species for agroforestry system, as the main aim to obtain the overall more output or the income from unit area. And also the care should be taken before the collection of seedlings, or maybe the seedlings that are going to be procured from different different sources. Okay, that should be brought to the agroforestry, and then we are going to plant with different agriculture crops.
Yes, sir.
So at what time next class is to Nindu? ಇನ್ನ ಹಾಫ್ ಅನ್ ಅವರ್ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ ನಿಮ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಈಗ
ಸರ್
ಇನ್ನ ಹಾಫ್ ಅನ್ ಅವರ್ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ನಿಮ್ದು
ಹ್ಞೂ ಸರ್ 25 ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಸರ್
ಓಕೆ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಫಿನಿಶ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ 20 ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಮುಗಿಸ್ತೀನಿ ಸೊ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ಅಗ್ರೋಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಅಗ್ರೋ ಎಕಾಲಜಿಕಲ್ ರೀಜನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಅಗ್ರೋಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ದ ಗ್ರೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಬೈ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಫಾರ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಓಕೆ The first one is agri-silviculture. It means by the cultivation of tree species with the crops. Maybe milliardubia. It is, for example, milliardubia, or it may be the teak. It is growing with the agriculture crops, mainly leguminous crops, or maybe the monocots. That is, may ragi, or it may be arsam, then red gram. Okay, all these are coming under agri-silviculture system. Then second one is the boundary plantation. It means the trees mainly planted on the boundaries, okay, along with the crop species. So next one is block plantation. Block plantation means it is planted in compact blocks, mainly in farm forestry, okay, along with the block of crops, like mainly ragi agirabodu, red gram agirabodu, okay, other it may be vegetables, or maybe the flower crops. Then energy plantation, that is mainly the plantation growing for needs of the fuel wood, that is the cultivation of crops, and also the tree species, mainly these agriculture crops cultivated during initial years, that is initial period of the tree species. So allele cropping means hedges and crops. Maybe this allele cropping I will discuss in future slides. Then agri horticulture system, that is cultivation of fruit trees with agriculture crops. Then agri silviculture means trees, that is woody perennials and fruit trees and the crops. Okay, as like another Sylvie, you know, agri Sylvie means it is a tree species and crops with water crops or maybe the pasture animals. Then Sylvie olericulture means you know, trees and vegetables. Okay, olericulture means it is cultivation of vegetables. It is called as olericulture. Okay, Sylvie olericulture means trees with vegetable crops. Then hortifacture means the fruit, mainly the fruit trees and you know, fodder crops. Then horti olericulture means fruit trees and vegetables. So next one is next agroforest system is Sylvie horticulture system, that is tree species or fruit trees, and sericulture, that is cultivation of mulberry. Then Sylvie pasture means trees and fodder crops or grass species. Okay, then forage forestry means the you know, forage trees and pasture, example like you know, growing you know, subabul or maybe other fodder trees with you know, pasture, that is grass. Okay, shelter belts, that is a trees plus crops, and windbreaks, trees plus it is also trees and crops. Then another agriculture system is the live fence. Okay, mainly the shrubs and under trees on the boundary. Okay, it is called as live fence. Okay, then the main advantages of these live fence means it provides you know, it controls the movement of livestock into the field, or it may, and also it acts as a barrier for the different pests. Okay, then aquaforestry means it is a tree plus fishes. Then horti apiculture means the fruit trees and honeybee. Then another is the homestead, and also it is called as home gardens. That is a multiple combinations of trees and fruit trees and vegetable cultivation. It is called as homestead agroforestry system. So this is about you know, different you know, characteristics of different tree species and also different agriculture, you know, agroforestry system that is practicing by Indian farmers. Okay, next the topic in the agroforestry system, that is shifting cultivation. Okay, the term shifting cultivation refers to the farming or the agriculture system in which mainly the land under natural vegetation is cleared, then the cropped with agriculture crops for the few years, and then left the you know untended while natural vegetation regenerate. Okay, mainly the cultivation phase is usually short, maybe 2 to 3 years they will cultivate the crops in the you know cleared land, but the regeneration phase known as you know, fallow or bush fallow phase, it is much longer. That is mainly it takes more than 10 to 20 year for the regeneration of different tree species in that cleared area. So the cleaning is usually made by slash and burn method, hence the name slash and burn agriculture came. Okay, and mainly employing simple hand tools, the you know, yeah, cleared for the agriculture purpose. Okay, during this period the soil having been depleted of its you know, fertility during the cropping period, and it regains its fertility through the you know, regeneration phase, mainly by the action of woody you know, vegetation, that is mainly by the tree species, that is litter falls, it may increases the you know, fertility of the area. So the farming cycle of these you know, shifting cultivation, the farmers mainly these shifting cultivation mainly followed in you know, northeast parts of India, mainly in Assam, you know, Mizoram and other northeast states. Okay, and it is also called as zoom cultivation. I will explain what is zoom cultivation and other names for this shifting cultivation. Okay, we'll see what is you know, different cycle of these shifting cultivation. First, the farmers are the people select the you know, the land. Then after selecting land, they will cut all the trees by slash and burn method. After cutting trees in that area, so they will burn all the residues, that is trees or maybe weeds and other unwanted plants in that area. Then after that, they will start cultivating mainly agriculture crops by direct sowing. They will not plant the trees agriculture crops by seedling planting or other methods of planting techniques. Mainly they will use different types of the types of the seed they will plant in, they will sow in that area. After once crop coming for the harvest, they will cut they will harvest the crops, and that area should be that area will be left for many period, that is abandonment of the wild site after 2 or 3 years. Okay, they will not cultivate any crops in the that area. So that time the cutted trees or maybe other plants will regenerate. It will add litter or the organic content to the soil. So as a result, it increases the fertility of the soil. So different terms used for the shifting cultivation in different parts of the world. Okay, mainly in Asia. So one is the term called as Thangia system. It is mainly in Burma region, and India this shifting cultivation called as a beaver, then Dania, then Deepa, then Yerka and Jhum cultivation, and also Kumari, then Penda, then Potu, like Podu. Okay, then also in America they will call as Kemail, then Milpa, like that. Another in Africa also some terms is there, so Mosale, then Tawi, like that. Okay, the shifting in different region the different names for these shifting cultivation. So coming to the different advantages and disadvantages of shifting cultivation. Okay, first one is it requires a small investment, that is the farmers they will not go for different flowing, maybe they will not flow the land then. Okay, so these are all decreases or reduce the investment by the farmers. Then also it is a simple growing method. Okay, simple growing method means the farmers are directly sow the seeds in the field, so that it will not require any other planting methods for the growing of the crops. Then third one is no need of animal labor power also. So and also it is environmental friendly because of its organic farming, that is the farmers they will not use any fertilizers then also pesticides for the plant production. So now fifth one is well fertile soil, because the area is cleared from the natural forest, that is the trees or other plants cleared from one area. Okay, that area already more fertile because of continuous leaf falling of leaves or leaves from the tree species. And sixth one is it may reduce the incidence of soil borne diseases. Okay, these slash and burn method it decreases the or destroys the different pests and diseases in the soil. Then also it can play a part in a pest management, that is the burning method. It is it will kill the different the pest or insects present on the layer, or it may be on the unwanted plants. Then some of disadvantages of these shifting cultivations are it is not a long period. Okay, the farmers only they will cultivate for 2 to 3 years. Okay, after that they will move to another land and they will clear that area, and they will start growing crops in new land. Then also destroying the habitats of wild animals. Okay, it is a major drawback of this shifting cultivation. Okay, then taking our life element, that is oxygen, okay, we will because that you know people will cut more the trees, simultaneously it decreases it depletes the quality of the air. Then also deforestation, okay, then troublesome to move around the all the time, okay, because in the natural forest area the movement mainly because of more trees or sometime in forest area it is difficult to move from one place to another place, okay, it may be create some problem for the farmers. So the different effects of these shifting cultivation, first one is shifting cultivation causes loss of mainly the flora and fauna, which includes the precious species of tree species, then also shrubs, then medicinal plants and minor forest produce, that is mainly the maybe the timber, roots or fruits, okay, these are called minor forest products. So on the next the effect of the shifting cultivation is, so it is an easy method of deforestation, okay, you know the people will cut the tree species by using simple hand tools, okay. The wild animals lost their shelter, that is by you know clearing the forest area, many of wild species they have lost their habitat. Then it causes heavy flood in the river below, okay, it deforestation increases the runoff of runoff by water, so maybe it causes the flood, okay. The siltation to the tanks, then also nalas, then rivers and reservoirs. Then next the effect of shifting cultivation is the ecology is disturbed and distorted, which never restored. Then it also causes soil erosion. The intensity of soil erosion depends on mainly the slope, then also different soil characteristics,
then crop coverage, then depth of the soil and also rainfall pattern, okay. If the crop coverage is more, the erosion will be the less, okay, the you know mainly the leaf litter or maybe the leaves controls the you know force of the raindrops, so that you know soil particles they will not move from one place to other place. So this is about you know shifting cultivation and different agroforestry systems that is practicing in India. So next class I will continue with another you know agroforestry system, that is Tangya cultivation or Tangya system of agroforestry, okay. I think next class I will do these topics. So if you have any question you can ask.
ಬ್ರಾಂಚಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸಿವ್ ಆಗಿ ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಡ್ ಆಗತ್ತಲ್ವಾ ಸರ್, ಸೊ ಸನ್ಲೈಟ್ ಅವೈಲಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಹ್ಯಾಂಪರ್ ಆಗಲ್ವಾ ಸರ್ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಗೆ?
ಸೊ ಅದನ್ನೇ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದು, ಟ್ರೀ ಸ್ಪೀಸೀಸ್ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡುವಾಗ ಸೊ ಲೆಸ್ ಬ್ರಾಂಚಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಯಾಟರ್ನ್ ಇರಬೇಕು ಅಂತ, ಒಂದು ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಒನ್ ಅಲ್ಲೂ ಹೇಳಿದ್ನಲ್ಲ, ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ದ ಟ್ರೀ ಸ್ಪೀಸೀಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ಏನು ಯಾವ್ದ್ರಲ್ಲೂ ಹೇಳ್ತಲ್ಲಮ್ಮ.
ಓಕೆ ಸರ್.
ಅದು ಏನು ಗೊತ್ತಾ, ಈಗ ಟ್ರೀ ಸ್ಪೀಸೀಸ್ ನಾವು ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡುವಾಗ ಲೆಸ್ ಬ್ರಾಂಚಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಯಾಟರ್ನ್ ಇರ್ಬೇಕು. ಈಗ ಆಗ ಇದಿರ್ಬ ಏನು ಮಿಲಿಯಾಡುಬಿಯಾ ಇದೆಯಲ್ವಾ, ಸೊ ಮಿಲಿಯಾಡುಬಿಯಾ ಈಗ ಬ್ರಾಂಚಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಯಾಟರ್ನ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಮತ್ತೆ ಇದು ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಮಹಾಗನಿ ಮಹಾಗನಿ ನೋಡಿದ್ರಲ್ಲ.
Yes, sir.
So the canopy spread is very less compared to other species like you know tamarind agirabodu, mango agirabodu, okay, then banyan trees, okay. So compared to these species you know the branching pattern of these species are you know less, and then also the teak also less branching pattern, it will go straight, okay. That species should be select for agroforestry. Then okay. If the more branch or more canopy means, so we have to you know prune the branches.
Okay,
so
sir.
That is also another practice in agroforestry to you know control you know ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಸನ್ಲೈಟ್ ಇದ್ ಮಾಡಕ್ಕೆ ಅದು ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ಅದು ಪ್ರೂನಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇದು.
ಸರ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಇದು ಶಿಫ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಕಲ್ಟಿವೇಶನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಅದು ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಲಿ, ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಫಾರ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ತರ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರಲ್ವಾ ಸರ್, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇದು ಟ್ರೀ ಬಯೋಮಾಸ್ ಮಾತ್ರ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಸರ್, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ವರ್ಮಿ ಕಾಂಪೋಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಬರ್ನ್ ಸರ್, ದೆನ್ ಹೌ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಇಟ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ ಟು ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಫಾರ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ಸರ್?
ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ ಮೇಡಮ್.
ಸರ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಫಾರ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ಇದು ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಲಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರಲ್ವಾ ಸರ್ ನೀವು ಇದು ಶಿಫ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಕಲ್ಟಿವೇಶನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ, ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಅದು ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಫಾರ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ತರ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ. ಬಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ್ದೇ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಮೆನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಏನ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗ್ತಿಲ್ವಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ಬರೀ ಅದು ಫ್ರೀ ಬಯೋಮಾಸ್ ಮಾತ್ರ.
ಒಂದ್ ನಿಮಿಷ, ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಫಾರ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಈಗ ನಾವು ಏನು ವರ್ಮಿ ಕಾಂಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಏನಕ್ಕೆ ಫಾರ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಲ್ಲ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಫಾರ್ಮಿಂಗ್, ಅದಷ್ಟೇ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಫಾರ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ಅಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಈ ಶಿಫ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಕಲ್ಟಿವೇಶನ್ ಏನಂದ್ರೆ ವಿತೌಟ್ ಏನು ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ಸ್, ಓಕೆ, ವಿತೌಟ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ನಾವು ಯಾವ್ದೇ ಅಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಫಾರ್ಮಿಂಗ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ. ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಎನಿ ಏನು ಅಡಿಷನಲ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ಸ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಔಟ್ ಸೈಡ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಎನಿ ಅಡಿಷನಲ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಶಿಫ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಕಲ್ಟಿವೇಶನ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಡ್ವಾಂಟೇಜ್. ಓಕೆ, ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ಈ ಟ್ರೈಬಲ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ಈಸ್ಟರ್ನ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್, ಓಕೆ, ಯಾವ್ದೋ ಒಂದು ಏರಿಯಾ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂತಾರೆ ಫಸ್ಟ್. ಅವರು ಒಂದು ಎಕರ್ ಗಟ್ಟಲೆ ಮಾಡಲ್ಲ, ಒಂದು ಹಾಫ್ ಒನ್ ಎಕರ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಒಂದು ಕಾಲ್ ಎಕರೆ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಅದನ್ನ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಫಸ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ ದ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ರೀಜನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಹೆಂಗಿರುತ್ತಂದ್ರೆ ಈಗ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಟ್ರೀ ಸ್ಪೀಸೀಸ್ ಲೀಫ್ ಆಲ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಆಗಿ ಡಿಕಂಪೋಸ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತವೆ ಲೀಫ್ ಎಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಏನಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ರಿಚ್ ಇನ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮಸ್, ಹ್ಯೂಮಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ರಿಚ್ ಇನ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಆರ್ ಸೋ ದ ಸೀಡ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಏನು ದಟ್ ಏನು ಒಂದ್ ನಿಮಿಷಮ್ಮ ನಂಗೆ ಫುಲ್ ಕಫ ಆಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು. ಆ ಏರಿಯಾದಲ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಸೀಡ್ಸ್ ನ ಸೋ ಮಾಡಿ ಸೋ ಕಲ್ಟಿವೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ. ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಈವನ್ ದ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ಏನು ಉಳುಮೆನ್ ಕೂಡ ಮಾಡಲ್ಲ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ. ಉಳುಮೆ ಅಂತ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ನೀವೇನು ಏನು ಮತ್ತೆ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಇವೆಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬರ್ತಾವಲ್ಲ, ಫ್ಲೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಡಿಸ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಇವೆಲ್ಲ, ಅವೆಲ್ಲ ಏನು ಮಾಡೋದೇ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಅವ್ರು ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಸೋಮ್ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತಾರೆ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ನ ಇದನ್ನ ಸೀಡ್ ನ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಶಿಫ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಕಲ್ಟಿವೇಶನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ. ಜುಮ್ ಕಲ್ಟಿವೇಶನ್ ಇಸ್ ಏನು ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನಾಲಜಿ ಫಾರ್ ಶಿಫ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಕಲ್ಟಿವೇಶನ್.
Yes, sir. Like, based on what those terminologies are derived, sir? Like, is it based on the place?
Alla, shifting cultivation andre iga ond area dalli alli irthare maadirtare ee area dalli crop belitu harvest maadibuttare. So harvest maadadaga enandre bere naavu inputs hakalalva, so that you know soil fertility will deplete soon. Okay, bega soil fertility deplete aguta area dalli. So next crop belibekandre avrige yav alli crop barodilla next area dalli. ಸೊ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರಂದ್ರೆ ಅವಾಗ, ಸೊ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಮೂವ್ ಟು ಅನದರ್ ಏರಿಯಾ. ಸೊ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಕಟ್ ಏನ್ ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ದಟ್ ಏನೋ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಏರಿಯಾ, ದೆನ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಏನ್ ಕಲ್ಟಿವೇಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ಸ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೈ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎ ಶಿಫ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಕಲ್ಟಿವೇಶನ್ ಅಂತ.
ಸರ್ ಅಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ಈಗ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ರೀಜನ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ನೇಮ್ಸ್ ಇಂದ ಕರೀತಾರಲ್ವಾ ಸರ್, ಆ ನೇಮ್ ಹೆಂಗ್ ಡಿರೈವ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಸರ್? ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಆರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಸರ್?
ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಆರ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಅದು ಒಂದೊಂದು ತರ. ಈಗ ಯಾವ ನಮ್ಮ ಇಂಡಿಯಾದಲ್ಲಿ ಶಿಫ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಕಲ್ಟಿವೇಶನ್ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ನಾರ್ತ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಮತ್ತೆ ಜುಮ್ ಕಲ್ಟಿವೇಶನ್ ನಾರ್ತ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾದಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂತ, ನಾರ್ತ್ ಈಸ್ಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಸೌತ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕೆಲವರು ಪೋಡು ಅಂತಾರೆ, ಕುಮಾರಿ ಅಂತಾರೆ ಇನ್ ತಮಿಳ್ನಾಡು ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕೇರಳ ರೀಜನ್, ಕುಮಾರಿ ಪೋಡು ಅಂತಾರೆ. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ದೇರ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್, ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ದಟ್ ರೀಜನ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಏನೋ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ರೀಜನ್ ಅಷ್ಟೇ.
ಓಕೆ ಸರ್, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.
ಓಕೆ ಮಾ. ಅಟೆಂಡೆನ್ಸ್ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರಾ
ಸರ್? ತಗೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಸರ್.
ಯಾರು 93 ಇತ್ತಲ್ಲ, 92 ಇದಾರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ.
ಹಾ ಸರ್, ತಗೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಸರ್.
ಸರ್
ಹಾ ಕೇಳಿ ಕೇಳಿ
ಸರ್, ಅದು ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಶೆಲ್ಟರ್ ಕಾನ್ಫರಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಐತಾರೆ ಸರ್, ಹಂಗಂದ್ರೆ ಏನ್ ಸರ್?
ಎಲ್ಲಿದೆಯೋ
ಇದಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ ಸರ್, ಇವಾಗ ಇರೋ ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ ಆದ್ಮೇಲೆ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ
ಶೆಲ್ಟರ್
ಕಾನ್ಫರಿಂಗ್
ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಮಾಡುವಾಗ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದಪ್ಪ?
ಸರ್ ಕೇಳಿಸ್ಕೊಂತಿದ್ದೆ ಬಟ್ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗಿರ್ಲ ಸರ್ ಅದು ಏಟ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಸರ್ ಇದೆ ಹಿಂದ್ಗಡೆ ಅದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಫಸ್ಟ್ 8 ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಸರ್
ಶುಡ್ ನಾವು ಶೆಲ್ಟರ್ ಕನ್ಫರ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್ ಶೆಲ್ಟರ್ ಕನ್ಫರ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಟ್ರೀ ಸ್ಪೀಸೀಸ್ ಗೆ ಇದ್ ಮಾಡಬಾರ್ದು ಅಂತ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಶೇಡ್ ಬರಬಾರ್ದು ಅಂತ ಸೊ ಈಗ ಮೋರ್ ಬ್ರಾಂಚಿಂಗ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಮೋರ್ ಕೆನೋಪಿ ಇದ್ರೆ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ಶೇಡ್ ಬರುತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಟ್ರೀ ಸ್ಪೀಸ್ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇರೆ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ಸ್ ಗೆ that should be not happen by the these three species
sorry sir that, thank you sir ha sir
so any other questions
excuse me sir
heli
sir in one of the slides you showed carbon sequestration can you explain how does it affect agroforestry
so carbon sequestration means sorry I forgot to explain that terminology so carbon sequestration means it is a capture and long term storage of the carbon in tree species mainly in the form of biomass okay the what the mainly the tree species do is they will capture or these carbon dioxide during their photosynthesis okay then also they will store as a biomass in tree okay in different parts like maybe in has a roots or in branches then leaves fruits maybe in am audible
yes sir
so mainly in different parts of tree species they will store these carbon okay that is called as carbon sequestration
yes sir how does deforestation affects this carbon sequestration
ಡಿಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಈಗ ನೀವು ಮೋರ್ ಟ್ರೀ ಸ್ಪೀಸೀಸ್ ನ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದಷ್ಟು ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಈಗ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ಗೆ ಮೇಜರ್ ಸಿಂಕ್ ಬಂದು ಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಬಂದು ಏನು ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಏನು
ಅಟ್ಮಾಸ್ಫಿಯರ್
ಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಅಟ್ಮಾಸ್ಫಿಯರ್ ಸಿಂಕ್ ಟ್ರೀಸ್
ಸಿಂಕ್ ಬಂದು ಟ್ರೀಸ್
ಸೊ
ದಟ್ ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ಇದನ್ನ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅದನ್ನ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕಂತ ಇನ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಯೋಮಾಸ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ ಸೊ ನಾವು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದಷ್ಟು ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಸ್ಟೋರೇಜ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತಿರ್ತದೆ ಇನ್ ಅಟ್ಮಾಸ್ಫಿಯರ್
ಓಕೆ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು
ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಎನಿ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ಸ್ I think someone asked sir whether government has any role in social forestry so definitely mainly in the governments in pancha like extension forestry then also urban these the government mainly involved in with community forestry and also in extension forestry okay the government involved in planting of different tree species okay mainly in panchayat land or maybe in different government lands okay government that is the waste lands belongs to the government okay I think I explained in that community forest alwa banu kumar so any other questions
sir last class in notes kalchi sir
ಯಾವತ್ತು ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀನಲ್ಲ ನೀವೇನು ಇಸ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದೇ ಇಲ್ವಾ ನೋಟ್ಸು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸು
ರೀಜನರೇಷನ್ ಅಫೋರೆಸ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಡಿಫೋರೆಸ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರಿ
ಕೊಟ್ಟಿಲ್ವಾ ನೋಟ್ಸು ಪಟೀಲ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿಲ್ವಾ
ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದ
ಸರ್ ಗ್ರೂಪಿಗೆ ಹಾಕಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಸರ್ ಗ್ರೂಪಿಗೆ ಹಾಕಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಸರ್
ಏ ಮತ್ತೇನು ಸಪ್ರೇಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಹೋಗ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಮೇಲ್ ಕಳಿಸ್ಬಿಟ್ರಪ್ಪ ಕಳಿಸ್ಬಿಡ್ತೀನಿ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಒಂದೊಂದೇ
ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸರ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸರ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸರ್ ನಾನು ಕಳಿಸ್ತೀನಿ ಬಿಡಿ ಇನ್ನೊಮ್ಮೆ
ಯಾರು ಕೇಳಿದ್ ನೋಟ್ಸ್
ದಿಲೀಪ್ ಸರ್ ದಿಲೀಪ್
ನಿಂಗೆ ಸಪ್ರೇಟ್ ಕಳಿಸ್ಬೇಕೇನಪ್ಪ ಹೋಗ್ಲಿ ಮೇಲ್ ಕೊಡಪ್ಪ ಕಳಿಸ್ತೀನಿ
ಇಲ್ಲ ಇಲ್ಲ ಪರವಾಗಿಲ್ಲ ಬಿಡಿ ಸರ್ ಕೇಳ್ತೀನಿ ಸರ್ ನಾನು
ವೀರೇಶ್ ಇದ್ದೀರಾ ನೀವು
ಸರ್
ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ಸ್ ಏನಾದ್ರು ಇರ್ತಾವ ನಿಮಗೆ
ಒಂದು ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಇದೆ ಸರ್
ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಏನದು ಹರ್ಷಿತ ಏನಮ್ಮ ಅದು ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಫಾರ್
ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಸರ್
ಕಾಂಪ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರಲ್ಲ ಈಗ ವುಡ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಗೊತ್ತಾ ವುಡ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂತಾರೆ ವುಡ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಮತ್ತೆ
ತ್ರೀ ಸ್ಪೀಶೀಸ್ ರಬ್ಬರ್ ಟೀಕ್ ಆಗ್ಬೋದಾ ಸರ್?
ರಬ್ಬರ್ ಸೊ ದ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವುಡ್ ಲಾಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಬರ್ತವೆ. ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಕಲ್ಟಿವೇಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ವುಡ್ಡಿ ಪೆರ್ನಿಯಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಏರಿಯಾ, ದೆನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟೇಶನ್. ಓನ್ಲಿ ದ ಫ್ಯೂಲ್ ವುಡ್ ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಲ್ಟಿವೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ರಿ.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸರ್.
ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಹೇಳಿ, ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಕೇಳ್ತಿದ್ರಲ್ಲ ಹೇಳಮ್ಮ. ರಬ್ಬರ್ ಅಂಡ್
ಟೀಕ್ ಸರ್.
ಹಾ
ಸರ್, ಅವು ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ಆಗ್ಬೋದಾ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದೆ ಸರ್.
ಏನಕ್ಕೆ ಅಂತ
ಸರ್? ಆ ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಗ್ರೋ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದಾ ಸರ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಗೋಸ್ಕರ ಅಂತ?
ಹಾ, ಗ್ರೋ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ರಬ್ಬರ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಯಾವ ರಬ್ಬರ್ ಅಮ್ಮ?
ಸರ್ ರಬ್ಬರ್ ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಗ್ರೋ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರಲ್ಲ ಸರ್ ವೆಸ್ಟರ್ನ್ ಗಾರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಕಡೆ ಎಲ್ಲ.
ಹಾ ಹಾ, ಗ್ರೋ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು, ನೋ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ ನೀವು
ಸರ್? ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ಕೇಳಿದೆ.
ಹಾ ಹಾ, ರಬ್ಬರ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ರಬ್ಬರ್ ಅದ ವುಡ್ ಆಫ್ ರಬ್ಬರ್ ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಪ್ಲೇವುಡ್. ರಬ್ಬರ್ ದೆನ್ ಟೀಕ್ ಅವೆಲ್ಲ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಪ್ಲೇವುಡ್ ಗೆಲ್ಲ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಇನ್ನೇ ವೀರೇಶ್
ಸರ್.
ವೀರೇಶ್ ಹೇಳಿ ಹೇಳಿ
ಸರ್. ಅಗ್ರೋಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಸಣ್ಣಗಿರೋ ಬಾರ್ಕ್ ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು, ಅಂತ ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು, ದಪ್ಪ ಇರೋದು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬಾರ್ದು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರಿ, ಯಾಕೆ ಸರ್?
ಈಗ ತಿನ್ ಬಾರ್ಕ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ತಿಕ್ ಬಾರ್ಕ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾ? ಇದು ಶೆಡ್ ಆಗ್ತಿರ್ತದ ಬೇಗ, ಅದ್ರದ್ದು ತೊಗಡೆ ಇರ್ತದಲ್ಲ ಬೇಗ ಬರ್ತಿರ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಿಯಂಟ್ ಲಾಸ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗ್ತದೆ, ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಿಯಂಟ್ ಲಾಸ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಟ್ರೀಸ್. ಸೊ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಈಗ ಬಾರ್ಕ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಶೆಡ್ ಆಗ್ತಿದ್ರೆ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಿಯಂಟ್ ಲಾಸ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ ಏನಪ್ಪ, ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಲಾಸ್ ಆಗಲ್ವಾ?
ಮತ್ತೆ ಬರುತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಸರ್,
ಮತ್ತೆ ಬರುತ್ತಾ? ಅದನ್ನೇ ಹೇಳ್ತಿರೋದು, ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಶೆಡ್ ಮಾಡಬಾರದು ಅಂತ. ಸೊ ತಿನ್ ಬಾರ್ಕ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಶೆಡ್ ಏನೋ ದ ಬಾರ್ಕ್ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆಂಟ್ಲಿ. ತಿಕ್ ಬಾರ್ಕ್ ಇದ್ದಾಗ ಬೇಗ ಬೇಗ ಶೆಡ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಇದು ಅಷ್ಟೇ, ಈಗ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಿಯೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ದೆನ್ ಬಯೋಮಾಸ್ ಬೇಗ ವೇಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಿರ್ತದೆ ಅಂತ.
ಸರಿ,
ಬೈ ತಿನ್ ಬಾರ್ಕ್ ಇರ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ ಅಗ್ರೋಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ಗೆ.
ಓಕೆ ಸರ್, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸರ್.
ಓಕೆ, ಎನಿ ಅದರ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ಸ್? So I am also facing some network issues now. ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಅಟೆಂಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಇದ್ರಾ ಒಳಗಡೆ? ಯಾರಾದ್ರೂ ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ರೆ ಮೆಸೇಜ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನನಗೆ ವಿತ್ ಯುವರ್ ಐಡಿ ನಂಬರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನೇಮ್. ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ ದೆನ್, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್
ಯು.
ಅರ್ಥ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತಾ? ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಇವತ್ತು ನಾನು ರೆಡಿ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ, ನಾನು ಮನೇಲಿದ್ದೆ. ಸೊ ಏನ್ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ನೊಂದ್ಸರಿ ಯಾವಾಗಲಾದ್ರೂ ಮಾಡೋಣ, ಆಯ್ತಾ?
ಓಕೆ ಸರ್.
ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ ಕೇಳಿ, ಇನ್ನೊಂದ್ಸರಿ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ಯಾವಾಗಲಾದ್ರೂ. ಸೊ ನನಗೂ ಟೈಮ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ನೋಟ್ಸ್ ರೆಡಿ ಮಾಡಕ್ಕೆ, ನಿನ್ನೆ ನೋಟ್ಸ್ ರೆಡಿ ಮಾಡಿ ಇವತ್ತು ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್. ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ ದೆನ್, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು
ಸರ್.
ಓಕೆ, ಬಾಯ್
ಬಾಯ್ ಸರ್.